tied down. You give me sympathy, bad dickly, instantly I feel so bad, like how could I be mad? You want some shit I don't want. You want some shit I don't did. We all got idols.
When I pulled this engine, I really wish I made a video on that. I was with a mate, and we used a sledgehammer and an angle grinder to get it out, pretty much. The whole car was $500, right? This whole car was $800, as is, and all the roof flying, that was normal back then. But anyway, this car was $500. It was a work car for my old job, running and driving. We used it to do the job. And yeah, when they got sick of it, they were gonna take it to the wreckers, and they said I could have it for $500, so I bought it. I knew it worked, and there was no weird engine noises, so I bought it. Oh yeah, it's the sticker I bought off Rod Knock himself. This thing, oil was pretty black, but I know it didn't have any ticks or knocks or anything, so that is eventually going in there, but gotta do all the wiring. This sump here, it's either this one. This is a B8 engine, by the way, which is the first generation of Barrow motors. These cars, they bolt up, I think, with the mismatch engine mount, so. But the K-frame doesn't clear this. It will hit that. But I think it's either the second generation Barrow engine. The sump is here. This hump is here, and then there's nothing there. It's either this one's good, or I need to get a different sump, or cut the sump out, weld it, whatever. I'll show you what engine's in this. Oh, Scheißerflugen. I've got, pretty much got the same car, my daily driver, is a EF Falcon, which is just like, shorter wheelbase, non-luxury version of this car. So hard to see, it's no light. Pretty bad footage, but anyway. Yeah, this is a single overhead cam, 4 liter, inline six. Not really that special. Does the job. This one's got 164 kilowatts to the wheels or to the fly engine, the flywheel. I mean, stock, and those. Those Barrow engines, first gens, are rated to like 184, 85, I can't remember. Which is, you know, more, but not that crazy. That whole engine's gonna have, I'm gonna do all the bearings. Like, all gaskets, all seals, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna bike it. Probably gonna spend like
$1 million.
And it's a first gen BA, which people think a shit, which, you know, the FG ones are better, they make more power standard, but won't matter because this is going to have big injectors in it. It's going to have 1000 cc injectors in it, new oil pump gears, new piston rings, new rods as well. I'm going to get more forged ones, H-beam rods. Oh yeah, and new valve springs. I'm not going to delete the aircon because it does get hot here. It might be Victoria, but it does get hot here. And this ain't gonna be my daily driver. It'll be on Club Rego, which is only probably quarter the price I pay for normal Rego. Oh, and extractors, but that can just wait completely. This is the stock BA computer. It came out of the BA car, which is what this engine was from. And apparently they're really customizable. You can tune them, flash tune them with shit. So I'm just gonna, instead of buying ECU, save like $1,000 or a couple hundred dollars. I'm gonna put that bolted up to there, which is the position in the BA. If you jerry-rigged it up, you could probably run this off the factory ECU, but this is dual VCT, double overhead, valuable cam timing. So unless you lock the cams together, and then the ECU would think it's a single cam, but, you know, fuck that. I want my VCT. Car's got a long way to go, but it's getting there. I did one ball joint in that video. Done all the brakes on it. Need to top up the fluid, actually, because
I had to bleed him again the other day when I was doing the ball joint. Anyway,
yeah, I painted this, I don't know what you call this, weather stripping, not really, because this is hard and it screws into the frame of the car in here. But I did a pretty shitty job. You feel it? Sort of rough. So that looks shit, tell me. Hard to tell on camera, but honestly, when you stand back, it doesn't look too bad. And you gotta install the speakers. Oh, and this car's pretty low too, like, that's my hand there. What's comparison? I don't know, it's pretty random, but that's a welding helmet. That's how low the car is. So I'm just blabbering on right now. It's all the things I need to do to it, really, but this window needs to be removed because there's, well, not certain, but I just want to make sure. There's, I bet you there's rust under there somewhere, bubbling. Maybe I won't. Maybe I just say fuck it. Yeah, maybe I do just say fuck it. I don't know, I'll get back to that. These quarter rear windows, rear quarter windows, they, I don't know, I don't think they need to come out. I mean, I can't see any rust at all, actually. But all this is cracked as shit. Boot absorbers need to be replaced. I bought some, they're on their way. Yeah, and then all the rusts. Undercarriage is pretty good, actually. Has fuck all rust on it. The behind the bumper, I pulled that off, and that's all got primer, and then this special rust coating stuff. I'm trying to... yeah, that stuff on it. And then I sprayed clear coat over it. I mean, not that you're going to see it, but just to protect it again. Front bumper I pulled off as well. I didn't primer it, but I just sprayed some of that rust protectant stuff. I mean, I did a pretty shit job. Might pull it off again because the bumper needs sanding as well and painting. Hopefully that's explained pretty much everything I need to do for the next years. Oh, and this. One more thing. Fucking hell. All this plastic, it's all sort of... that's just vinyl wrapping. That's just nothing, actually. Don't even know why I'd worry about that. Yep. Instead of a respray, I'm going to do repairs like that, the bogs, and paint it myself, get like a mixture up. All the bits of paint that aren't fucked and cracked or dinted or scratched or rusty, I'm just going to polish it. And with that new paint spray, I'm going to try and merge it into it seamlessly, but we'll see what happens. And if I screw up, I'll just get it done professionally. I'm trying to do it sort of on the cheap, but not. I want it looking really good. Oh, and I replaced the headlights as well, forgot to mention. Because these are all, I mean, they're not, you can't really see in the camera, but they're real yellowed. Look like smoker's fucking fingers. The plastics that go around the roof line, I think I said in the last video, I'm wood graining them all. Fake wood grain, plastic vinyl, but I reckon it'll look cool. All the clips broke. So I had to glue, super glue all these ones I had to make up, which suck, because they're all going to probably break, and I'm going to have to buy metal clips for it again.